Hello everyone, my name is Dirk Stenger, and yeah, I'm talking about the current state of degree. So actually there were co-authors, so Stefan Reichelm, Thorsten Friebe, Andrea, two of them are sitting there, they were co-authors and are also in the degree TMC, but more data. So first I'm telling you what is degree and what can you do with the degree. Then I'm informing you about the news and yeah, what is coming in the close future. And finally I'm talking a little bit about the degree TMC and the community, how everything is organized. So I'm a diplom geographer. Yeah, and since 2012 I'm working for Datalon. So the yeah, main area of work of Latlon is doing implementations for OGC standards like WMS, WFS, and so on. And but we also yeah, work close together with the OGC, especially when it comes to maintaining the test suite. So there's another presentation tomorrow about that. And also, yeah, I'm an active committer of the degree project. Okay, but first, what is degree? So degree was started in 2002 and is an OSGEO project since 2010. Has an LGPL2.1 license, and yeah, at the bottom you can you can see a screenshot of the OSGEO website of degree. Degree implements yeah, server side standards. So there's a support for the full Inspire stack, including WMS, WMTS, WFS, and CSW. Yeah, also it's possible to configure the Inspire data themes to actually provide Inspire services. Also, degree is OGC reference implementation for several standards, so you can see them on the right. Yeah, that's the OGC compliance badge. So yeah, mainly all the major versions of WFS, WMS, WMTS, and GML are reference implementation. Yeah. Also, there's a Docker image for degree. So it's uploaded to Docker Hub, and you can see the link here, and everyone is invited to pull it and to try it. So it's very easy to install a degree like this. So now I come to a few numbers. So yeah, these are some statistics about the degree GitHub repository. So there are 77 forks, 68 stars, and 23 watchers. So yeah, there's a quite a lot of people who are interested in degree. Also, there are yeah, 23 committers and 202 releases were created on GitHub. So you can see yeah, many people are watching this project, and as you can see, the 202 releases, there's yeah, there are many releases also in the recent time. Those releases, of course, include bug fix releases, so also very small ones. Okay, and now I'm telling you what is new and what we are we planning for the close future. So again, I'm starting with numbers. So last year, degree 3.4 was finally released. So before that, 3.3 was the current stable version. And you can see yeah, in 3.4 there are 30 new features, 112 enhancements, 173 bug fixes. So quite a lot happened between 3.3 and 3.4, and I encourage everyone to use 3.4. Since then, so that release was created last year, and since then we created 8 minor releases. So the current version is 3.4.8, and yeah, since then there are new 10 new enhancements, 13 bug fixes. So yeah, There also happened a lot in the last year, but more, so there's no new feature, so we are more trying to make degrees stable. Okay, yeah, Inspire. So as I already said, Degree is capable to provide Inspire services. So yeah, there's a website with Inspire tools, like maintained by the JRC, and Degree is also described there as a possible implementation to provide Inspire services. Also, yeah, sometimes it's quite complex to configure an Inspire service, but there are several examples for Degree configurations yeah, to provide, for example, protected sites and cadastral parcels. And also, so those are by us, by Ludlow, and there are also several other Inspire configurations provided by other people. So these are just yeah, three examples we found. Okay, now I come to the next topic, GeoJSON. Yeah, so as you know, it's popular encoding, which can easily be used by JavaScript clients. So we decided to implement GeoJSON for the WFS as a yeah, custom encoding format. Yeah, that feature is already existing, and there's a pull request for that. But the pull request is not merged yet because it includes schema changes we do not want to put in the current 3.4 line. So yeah, this feature is planned for Degree 3.5. Yeah. But the code is already implemented, so everyone can check out the branch and test it. Now I come to the next feature, the OGC API for features. So everyone has probably heard about it, but I give a short overview first what the OGC API for features is. So it's a new standard defined by the OGC currently. So it's not an official standard yet, but it's still in the voting process. So currently, OGC members can vote if OGC API for features shall become an official OGC standard. So yeah, the I don't know the exact date when it ends, but I'm very sure that yeah, the new standard will be released soon. Also. Yeah, there's already so the standard is modularized. So the core standard just contains very basic stuff, and yeah, there's already a new development ongoing for more advanced modules. Okay, one hint. So in the past, OGC API for features was called WFS 3.0, but it was renamed to OGC API features. Because yeah, it's a complete rewrite of the WFS. Actually, it's capable to retrieve features, but it's done completely different. So the OGC decided to choose a new name. Yeah, the paradigm is to yeah, concentrate on well-known industry standards instead of doing WFS-specific stuff. So yeah, it's closer to well-known technologies and concepts. So one important thing is that it's resource-orientated, so a RESTful approach is introduced. Also, OpenAPI is used, describing the API, so there is no capabilities document anymore. And in the past, the GML encoding was mandatory, the most important encoding for OGC services. But in this case, there is no mandatory encoding, but the specification proposes to use GeoJSON, and but also HTML and GML. But GeoJSON and JSON will probably play a bigger role in the future. Okay, the status and Degree, so there is an issue for that. We are currently collecting funding and doing quite good with it, so I'm pretty confident that there will be a pull request soon, and yeah, this feature will be supported by Degree as well. Okay, and another topic we are currently working on is the JDK support. If you want to use Oracle JDK commercially, you have to pay a lot of money. So we decided to move to OpenJDK. So in the future, yeah, OpenJDK will be the JDK built to use. But there's still a lot, there's still some work to do because we want to move to OpenJDK 11, which is the latest long-term supported version. And currently Degree is not even running with it, and of course we have to make sure that it's compiling with OpenJDK. When these changes are done, Degree will officially not be backwards compatible with JDK 8, but that's of course also a future thing. So there are two issues for that, and we are already working on that. Okay. Now I come to the Degree Team C. The Team C is the technical management committee, and it's like I would say doing most of the management work in the project. It's deciding about new features, new bug fixes. So it's evaluating a pull request and deciding if they are if they are merged into the project or if there's anything to be improved in the pull request. It's the Team C is creating the releases, developing policies. Of course, is reviewing everything and is responsible for the whole project infrastructure. For example, the website, which was recently updated, and but also for the Nexus, so for the artifact repositories, Jenkins, etc. The Team C members are Raya Kopier, Thorsten Frieben, Stefan Reichel. So two of them are sitting there in the front. So that's Stefan and Raya. So if you have any questions about Degree, maybe later, you can ask me or, of course, them, because I would say all of us are Degree experts. In general, as I already said, the Team C is there to ensure a high quality of the project and to do the coordination of all technical activities. One important thing is that the Team C is not implementing bug fixes, enhancements, or features. So that's a part the community should do, or of course, for example, the company Latlon, of course, is also implementing bug fixes, enhancements, and features. Okay, currently the Team C is updating the server infrastructure. It's quite old and takes a lot of time. So we are sitting on that, and there's still a lot of stuff to do. One important thing is that there are regular Team C meetings, roughly every 2 weeks, and everyone is invited to join them. So actually, you have to take a look at the chat log of the last meeting to see when the next meeting is. But if you join those meetings there, you can, I would say, directly influence. If you want a pull request to be merged, you can say that, and then everyone is thinking about it. So that always helps. Or if you want to improve any pull requests, that's always welcome. Of course, you also get the latest details via the mailing list. Okay, now I come to the Degree community. So recent activities of the community were a community meeting at the Foskis in Dresden. So that's the German Phosphor G, And we had more than 20 attendees, so that was quite good. And we had very good discussions. I think the meeting was over 2 hours, so it was very long, and we had a lot to discuss. Okay, of course, for the community, there are several other channels to communicate with us. The mailing list, GIS Stack Exchange can be used to ask questions. As I already said, you can join the TMC meeting to help us merging pull requests and to propose new things. also, it's, you're very welcome to provide pull requests. And everything can be found on the degree website. And please keep in mind that the community is the most important part of degree. So it's not the TMC, but it's the community. It's the most important part. And support of the community is always welcome. So we have 64 issues labeled with contributions welcome, 35 with funding welcome. So if you have any ideas or if you want to fund anything, you can just take a look at the issue tracker. There are many ideas what we can do in the future. Several companies created a new version of Degree. It's called Degree Enterprise Edition, which has an enhanced support. So if you're interested in that, you can just check out those websites. Yeah, so it's a degree edition which is basing on the community edition. Okay, thank you very much. And do you have any questions?
So very good in time. So we have more time for questions.
Hi, thanks for a great talk there. I might have missed it on the slide, but I was wondering if there's a timeline for the OGC API work. Timeline, any idea when there might be a pilot version up for the OGC API?
Yeah. A timeline for when the standards actually published, or
Timeline for the work with Degree supporting it.
Ah, okay. Actually, I cannot give you a real timeline because it's not completely sure yet. But I would say. So we will probably do it this year, but I cannot say when the pull request will be created and then merged. So that can also take some time. So probably next year then, but I cannot give you an exact date, unfortunately.
No, fair enough. Okay, thanks anyway.
Just for my understanding, normally in a OSGEO project, you talk about a PSC, so that's what you call TMC, or?
Yeah, correct. So it's a little bit complicated. So that's also a PSC, so that's both for Degree. But practically, the TMC is doing almost all of the work now, so that's also. So we are thinking about changing that and restructuring the whole management thing. But there's a PLC and a TMC, and the PLC is more for the management stuff, and the TMC more for the technical.
Yep. Okay. More questions? Okay, Dirk, thank you very much for your presentation.